Throughout history, it has been worshipped as a god or goddess. Apollo, Sura, Melina, Amaterasu. Deities whose nightly departure is feared, but whose daily arrival is praised. 99% of the mass of our solar system is contained within its volume. And without it, I would not be standing here talking to you today. What is it? The Sun! My name is Professor Robert Walsh, and I'm an astronomer at the University of Central Lancashire. I work with NASA to observe the Sun. The Sun is a star, our closest star. It is a huge globe of electrified gas, its energy resulting from nuclear reactions deep down in the solar core. It's mostly hydrogen, then there's helium, and then a range of elements, including metals like iron. To us here on Earth, it may seem to be the center of the universe, but technically, that's not true. This is an image from the Hubble Space Telescope, a tiny patch of the night sky, about the tenth the size of a full moon as observed from Earth. Here you see thousands of galaxies, millions and billions of stars, stars like our Sun. This galaxy is our Milky Way. The Sun and our solar system reside in a backwater edge of one of the spiral arms. Eight planets rotate around the Sun. We are on the third one, Earth, in what is known as the Goldilocks Zone. It's not too close, it's not too far away, it's not too hot, it's not too cold, just right. We are here because the Sun is here, providing the conditions for life to flourish on our planet. So the Sun's a big deal, but what do we know about it? We know it's incredibly far away. It takes light 8 minutes to travel the 150 million kilometers, that's about 93 million miles, from the Sun to our terrestrial environment. We know it's incredibly dense. 99% of all the material in the solar system resides in the volume of the star. We know it's incredibly large. 109 Earths can fit across the diameter of the Sun. An unbelievable 1.3 million Earths in the volume of the star. And we know it's incredibly important. Life on Earth depends on the Sun. And that's why astronomers at the University of Central Lancashire have partnered with NASA to capture and analyse images of the Sun in unprecedented detail. Our researchers are working to understand the physics of the Sun and how solar activity impacts upon life on Earth. These images are taken from outside the Earth's atmosphere. NASA's Solar Dynamics Observatory orbits the Earth and stares continuously at the Sun on our behalf. Special solar filters, solar sunglasses, I suppose, allow us to pick out different portions of the light from the Sun, distinct parts of the electromagnetic spectrum, in this case of extreme ultraviolet light. The red coloured filter allows us to observe the chromosphere. Dominated by helium, we see large eruptions spew out from the surface of the Sun. The temperature here is about 50,000 degrees. The yellow coloured filter shows us the outer atmosphere, or the corona. This is iron, a metal on the Earth, but an electrifying gas in the atmosphere of the star. With startling temperatures of over a million degrees, the electrons get ripped from the iron atoms and form a plasma. That plasma gets channeled along the magnetic field that arches out from the surface of the Sun to produce complex loop-like structures. But our Sun is not a tranquil, benign source of light and energy. Solar storms and solar flares rage from the Sun, carrying billions of tons of electrified gas out into interplanetary space. Some of these eruptions are huge, like this one. This is not a Hollywood special effect. This is actual footage of an incredible eruption from your star. And the fun really starts when solar storms head down towards the Earth. Our solar shield, the Earth's magnetic field, can protect us from solar storms and the effects of space weather. But sometimes, if the conditions are just right, solar storms break through the Earth's magnetic field. High energy particles travel down into the Earth's atmosphere to create the aurora borealis, or northern lights. These shimmering curtains of light are formed when the high energy particles from the sun slam into atoms in our atmosphere, excite them, and then the excess energy is released as wave packets of light. Green is oxygen. Red, that's nitrogen, a beautiful byproduct of solar storms. But there are malevolent aspects to solar storms as well. Our dependence on satellite technology can be compromised by them. Fragile electronics can be short-circuited. Guidance systems can become disorientated. Satellites threatened by solar storms. But we can study the sun and try to predict its behavior. And this understanding does not just benefit us here on Earth. The International Space Station orbits our planet. And in 2016, we have on board a British astronaut, Tim Peake. Tim and his fellow astronauts would not want to be in a spacewalk when a solar storm is striking our planet. They have to go to a shielded part of the space station because the radiation increases fourfold in a matter of minutes. The sun is having a bit of a midlife crisis at the moment. It's 4 to 5 billion years old. And in another 4 to 5 billion years, it will become a red giant and possibly envelop the Earth. Another 4 billion years after that, it becomes a white dwarf and shines no more. Our planet is intimately tied to the life cycle of our closest star. But 4 to 5 billion years is a long time. Right now, let's enjoy these images of the sun, captured by NASA's Solar Dynamics Observatory and brought to you by the University of Central Lancashire. We hope you'll grasp something new about your star. And if nothing else, you'll see the sun in a completely new light.